Hello everybody, today we are going to make a sculpture of a caterpillar, and then we are going to use the body of caterpillar to make a butterfly. In this example I am using yellow clear balloon with about 9 inch long flat tail to make the caterpillar. We are going to make a chain of 6 tulip twists. Let's twist the first soft about half an inch long bubble. Let's force the first bubble about 1 inch inside of the balloon. In this example I'm using clear color balloon to make it easier for you to see what I'm doing and how. Hold the first bubble inside of the balloon. At that point we twist the second about half an inch long bubble. This way we lock in the first bubble inside of the balloon. Now the first bubble is inside of the balloon and it has 2 layers. We have made the first tulip twist. We have to repeat the same steps over and over again. Force the second bubble about 1 inch deep inside of the balloon. Hold the second bubble inside of the balloon. Twist the third soft about half an inch long bubble. This way you lock the second bubble inside of the balloon. At this point we have made 3 bubbles. The first and the second bubble are locked inside of the balloon. And now we force the third bubble about 1 inch deep inside of the balloon. Hold the third bubble inside of the balloon. Twist the fourth soft about half an inch long bubble. We have made a chain of 4 bubbles. 3 bubbles are inside of the balloon and the fourth bubble outside of the balloon. Making tulip twist takes some skills and practice, so don't get disappointed if you didn't get it right away. Keep trying. Practice makes it perfect. Let's force the fourth bubble about 1 inch deep inside of the balloon. Hold the fourth bubble at that point. And then we twist the fifth soft about half an inch long bubble, locking the fourth bubble inside of the balloon. What we are going to do next totally depends on what kind of sculpture we want to make. And there are a couple variations for sure. Right now we have a chain of 5 bubbles. Alright, you know, let's make the simplest one balloon caterpillar. Let's force the fifth bubble about 3 inch deep inside of the balloon. Hold the fifth bubble inside of the balloon. And then we twist the sixth about 3 inch long bubble. Gently pull your finger out of the sixth bubble. And let's force the fifth bubble slightly back inside of the sixth bubble to secure the lock. The rest of the balloon is the seventh bubble. We have to deflate the rest of the balloon. I'm going to use scissors to cut a little hole at the very end of the balloon. And then we deflate the seventh bubble. The chain of the first 5 bubbles remains inside of the balloon. The only sixth bubble stays outside of the balloon. This way the sixth bubble will represent the head of the caterpillar and the rest of the bubbles will represent the body of the caterpillar. Squeeze the air out of the seventh bubble. You may want to twist the body bubbles again to force the air out of the seventh bubble. Start twisting bubbles from the fifth bubble, fourth, third and so on to the first bubble. Each of the first 5 bubbles made of 3 layers. It actually makes them virtually indestructible. Now let's use a permanent marker to draw the face of our caterpillar. Eyes, little nose, big smile. There are different ways we can use this sculpture. We can make it as a handle for a sword or a mug or a squishy toy. Congratulations, we have made simple one balloon caterpillar. The caterpillar will look much better with antennas. Inflate about 2 inch long bubble. I use red balloon. Split the bubble on 2 bubbles of the same size. Let's force and keep each bubble in upper side ends of the balloon. Make sure you're making 2 bubbles of the same size. You have to prevent the airflow between bubbles. tie a knot in the middle of the balloon. Just make sure to check the size of the bubbles before you tie the knot. Okay, we have made the antennas. I have already made new caterpillar body. So now I'm just going to attach the antennas to this new caterpillar body. At this moment the body is made of 5 bubbles. There are 4 bubbles inside of the balloon. The 5th bubble is outside of the balloon. Let's place the knot of the red balloon next to the 5th yellow bubble. And now we force the red knot with the 5th yellow bubble about 3 inch deep inside of the balloon. Hold the red knot with the 5th yellow bubble inside of the yellow balloon. At this point we twist 6 soft about 3 inch long yellow bubble. Gently pull your finger out of the yellow balloon. At the same time we pull the 5th bubble slightly back inside of the 6th yellow bubble just to secure the lock. The rest of the balloon is the 7th yellow bubble. We have to deflate it. Let's do it same way as we did previously. Use scissors to cut little hole at the very end of the yellow balloon. Now we squeeze the air out of the 7th yellow bubble. We push the air out in same order as we did before. Start from the 5th bubble. Hold it and keep twisting the 4th, 3rd, 2nd and the 1st bubbles. Remember to hold all bubbles to prevent air coming back into the 7th bubble. This way we have made a caterpillar with antennas. Now we can attach wings to the caterpillar body to make a butterfly. I'm going to use one balloon to make 2 pairs of wings. Inflate a blue balloon leaving about 2 inch flat tail. We are going to make 2 pairs of different size wings. Let's find 1/3 of the balloon. At this point we twist the 1st, about 11 inch long bubble. Measure the size of the 2nd bubble. It should be the same as the 1st bubble, about 11 inch long. Lock both ends of the chain of the 1st 2 bubbles in 1 lock twist. Force the nozzle of the balloon through the loop of the bubbles to secure the knot. Lock all ends of the 1st 2 bubbles in 1 lock twist. We have made the 1st pair of wings. Now let's twist the 3rd soft about 3 inch long bubble. Now we are going to split the rest of the blue balloon on 2 bubbles of the same size to make the 2nd pair of smaller wings. Let's squeeze the balloon first to make it softer and to get rid of the long flat tail. Twist the 4th soft in this example about 6 inch long bubble. Make sure the rest of the balloon is the same size as you made the 4th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in 1 lock twist. Lock all ends of the last 2 bubbles in 1 lock twist. Okay, we have made 2 pairs of wings, different size. Now we are going to attach the butterfly wings to the caterpillar body. We can attach the 1st pair of wings between the head and the 5th yellow bubble. Or we can attach the 1st pair of wings between the 5th and the 4th yellow bubble. Let's do it this way. And the last 2 blue bubbles will lock between the 3rd and the 2nd yellow bubbles. Alright, we attach the wings to the body. We can leave the sculpture as it is. Or we can lock both ends of the 3rd blue bubble in 1 lock twist. At the same time we will lock both ends of the chain of 2, the 3rd and the 4th yellow bubbles in 1 lock twist. The 4th and the 3rd yellow bubbles will represent the legs of the butterfly. In nature the butterfly is supposed to have 6 legs, I think so. I think it is not big deal for this sculpture, right? Okay, let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Now we can rearrange the wings in a different order if you want. Well, I like it this way. The large size wings in front, closer to the head. Here's the top view, the side view, the bottom view. Here's the legs. Here's the front view. And now we can use a dark permanent marker to draw the face of the butterfly. Big nice eyes, little nose, and of course, big smile. Congratulations, we have made a butterfly. Let's take a look again. Here's the front view. That's the top view. The side view. And the bottom view. Let's see again what we have made today. The evolution of caterpillar to butterfly. First we have made the caterpillar, the simple one balloon caterpillar. Then we added antennas to caterpillar. And then we use the caterpillar body with antennas to make the butterfly. That's enough for today. Have fun and happy twisting!